Psalm 2 is really the first psalm because the very first psalm, Psalm 1, is introductory. That's the psalm that says you should be meditating in the Torah, the law of God, night and day. You wake up in the morning thinking about it, you go to sleep at night thinking about it. So that's your preoccupation with God's words. It says, why are the nations in an uproar? Why are they so mad? Why are the peoples devising a vain thing, futility? The kings of the earth, right? The governors of different states and the kings and rulers of the nations are taking their stand and taking counsel together against Yahweh. That's all caps. You know, in your Bible, you have all caps for Lord. That's the word Yehovah. That's more likely to be the correct pronunciation, but it doesn't matter whether you say Yahweh or the Lord or Yehovah, and against his Messiah. Two different persons, his Messiah, his anointed one. What are they saying? Verse 3, tear their fetters apart. So God and his Messiah, Jesus Christ, are binding these people. We want to get rid of these fetters. Give us our freedom. Cast away their cords from us. And then God laughs. It's a very rare thing in the Bible that God laughs, mocks. He laughs at them. The Lord, that Adonai in the Hebrew, that's the title for God, who is otherwise Jehovah or Yahweh. Then if you use a title for him, it's Adonai, the Lord, scoffs at them. Then he, the Lord God, will speak to them in his anger, terrify them. I would think so. You'd think they'd be shaking in their boots, wouldn't you? Terrify them in his fury and saying, as for me, Adonai, the Lord God, I, Adonai, the Lord God, have installed my king, my Messiah, upon Zion. Well, we know where Zion is. Zion is not in heaven. Zion is a place on the earth. The whole point is he's coming back to sit on the throne in Israel. You have all this insanity in churches about amill and premill and postmill. That's nothing to argue about. Oh, I've got my interpretation. You've got... No. That's not going to do. The kingdom is essentially future. That's why you're praying, thy kingdom come. And you can go to Jerusalem today. You won't find Jesus sitting on the throne of David because this hasn't happened. This is not obvious to a lot of Calvinistic churchgoers. Okay, so there is God laughing at them. I've put my king, or will have. This is a prophecy, and so you say it's already happened. It hasn't happened, actually. But I intend to put my king on my holy hill. Verse 7 says, I will surely tell of the decree of Yahweh, Yehovah, if you like.